Hi, and welcome to Quirky Books with Katie. Today I am going to be doing the book scenario tag. And I was tagged to do this a while back by Becca Awesome Booknut, so thank you, Becca, for tagging me to do this video. Question number one. You have to get rid of all your books, and you can only keep one from each of these genres: contemporary, fantasy, nonfiction, and one other genre of your choosing. What books do you keep? So the contemporary book that I would keep is The Day Before by Lisa Schroeder. This is a book told entirely in verse, and it is about this girl, and she's about to have a big change in her life, and before this happens, she wants one day to herself, so she goes out and kind of has her own little adventure, and I love this book so much, so I would definitely have to keep this. For fantasy, I would pick Throne of Glass by Sarah J. Maas. This book has been receiving so much hype lately, and I think it totally deserves its hype. It is about this girl who is going to be the assassin for the kingdom that she lives in, and this is such an amazing book. For nonfiction, I don't really read a lot of nonfiction, so I decided to switch it up and do historical fiction. And for that, I would have to go with The Book Thief by Marcus Zusak. This is just such a timeless book about words and the power of words. And this is an amazing book that is certainly going to be a classic someday. And for the pick your own genre, I did new adult, and the book that I picked is Maybe Someday by Colleen Hoover. Colleen Hoover is kind of the queen of new adult right now, and this book is told from two points of view, and it's about these two musicians and their relationship. And this book just destroyed me emotionally, and it is an amazing book, and I think it's a really good book if you're trying to get into new adult. Question two. You are at the bookstore and you hear a teenager telling their mom they don't like to read, but their mom insists they pick something. You walk over and recommend a book you think is great for people who aren't big on reading. What book is it? For this, I would have to pick Cinder by Marissa Meyer. I think this book really has something for everyone. It is about a futuristic world where cyborgs exist, and our main character Cinder is a cyborg, and this is a great series of retellings. It's filled with action, adventure, romance. It's very easy to understand the world, and I think that it really does have something for everybody. Question three. You're not feeling yourself and need a pick-me-up. Which book do you read to put yourself in a great mood? For this, I would have to say Anna and the French Kiss by Stephanie Perkins. I love this book so much. If anyone ever needs a contemporary recommendation, I don't care if they read or if they don't read, I will always recommend this book. This book never fails to put a smile on my face. I've read it at least 5 times, and I just love it so much. Question four. You go back in time for a day to your teenage years. What book would you most likely have caught yourself reading? Now, I am a teenager, but I decided to change this question and make it when I was in middle school, and for this I'd have to say The Lightning Thief by Rick Riordan. The Percy Jackson series is a series that I've loved for such a long time. I started reading this series when I was 11 years old, and I was completely obsessed with the series. I loved the world and the characters, and it was one of my favorites, and it still is to this day. Question five. Your friend surprises you with a 4-day trip, and you have to 1 hour to pack. Which book do you bring to read on the way? For this, I'd have to say Mistborn, The Final Empire by Brandon Sanderson. This book has received so much hype lately. It's supposed to be a fantastic fantasy. I'm about 100 pages through, and this would be a perfect book to finish on a giant road trip. Question six. Your house has been robbed, but don't worry, everyone is safe. But your bookshelf has been raided. What's the book you really hope is safe? For this, I'd have to say Jane Eyre by Charlotte Bronte. This is my special Barnes & Noble Classic Edition, and I love this book so much, and I love this copy of this book, and I would be so upset if something happened to it. Question 7. Your friend borrows a book and returns it in awful condition. Do you A, just pretend you haven't noticed, B, ask them to repurchase it, or C, secretly do the same to something of theirs? For this, I'm not a very confrontational person, so I would probably pretend I didn't notice it, although I would be very mad and probably give the person the silent treatment, because I would not be happy if someone returned one of my books in awful condition. So now I'm going to pick some people to tag for this. I'm going to tag Maddie and Gabby from Two Book Teens, Grace from Loving Dem Books, Rachel from YA Perfectionist, Tori from Victoria Marie, and Allison over at Book Gossiper. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you subscribe to my channel, and I hope you have a fantastic day.